Computational design of metallophone contact sounds. Musical instrument metallophones typically conform to well-understood design spaces, such as the scaled bars of a glockenspiel. However, even these bars are hand-tuned afterwards to create the right sound, and the shape design is rigidly set. Can we use computation and digital fabrication to simplify the difficult manual process of metallophone creation and expand their design spaces to 2D and 3D shapes? This problem is related to acoustic design and engineering, where recent works have exploited modal analysis to build musical instruments like saxophones and improve violin bridges, or have analyzed vibrational stress for structural integrity. The pioneering work of Umatani and colleagues applies forward design to create metallophones, giving feedback to the user of the fundamental frequency as they interact. We take an inverse functional specification approach. Our method takes as input a fabrication material, a parameterized input shape, an impact location, and a user-specified target spectrum consisting of both a set of desired frequency values and their corresponding amplitudes. Given the desired sound spectrum and a shape sound simulation, we pre-process them by matching the fundamental frequency between the two spectra with an isotropic scaling optimization. Then, the major peaks in frequency of the isotropic scaled shape are mapped to the desired overtones in the target spectra by minimizing the L2 norm error. Then, we solve an inverse shape design problem using a new global nonlinear optimization algorithm. During each step of design space exploration, the current contact sound spectrum computed using higher-order finite element analysis is compared to the user-desired frequencies and amplitudes. The search ceases once the two spectra are sufficiently close. We fabricate these optimized metallophones from aluminium with a water jet by milling or by 3D printing in a bronze alloy. In a final step, we optimize a stand for the fabricated piece so that user-selected frequencies are not artificially dampened. During optimization, using higher-order FEM elements is essential for accuracy. We compare the difference between our non-optimized input shapes and our output shapes. We also compare the difference between our simple linear scaling optimization and our full nonlinear optimization. We also compare the difference between a professionally made instrument and our metallophones. Our method is flexible to many different shape parameterizations. For instance, for shape changes through freeform deformation and perforation, we show an ellipse being optimized in many different ways to the same target frequency and overtones. Of course, any approach has limitations. Shapes with naturally dense spectra with no particular frequency are difficult to optimize, such as this triangle. That said, our approach can produce fine control of overtones, even at non-harmonic frequencies. We demonstrate this with a piece which creates a chord C, E, and G from a single strike. We also optimize a shape to create two different notes when hit at different locations. Lower frequencies are hard to optimize because the vibration mode peaks are dense, making overtone control hard. With larger shape changes and perforation, we are able to suppress nearby unwanted overtones. Our final example uses 3D metal printing to produce cups of different notes. In conclusion, our technique allows new aesthetic acoustic designs for musicians, artists, and engineers to explore.